Rural Texas, 1979. Sheriff Dentler goes to the place where a very bad thing happened. There is a dead body covered up outside the house, and blood is all over the front porch. When Dentler goes into the house, the deputy tells him to go further inside to see something really terrible. Dentler is shocked by what he sees. The day before, a woman named Maxine Minx, who wants to become famous, is preparing to travel to Houston, Texas to make a pornographic movie called The Farmer's Daughter. Her boyfriend, Wayne, who is in charge of making the movie, takes her there with the other people involved, such as the writer-director RJ. His girlfriend, Lorraine, who helps with the sound, and the actors Bobby Lynn and Jackson, who are also a couple. They stop at a gas station to refuel. Wayne and Maxine enter the store to do some shopping. Wayne tells Maxine that if RJ does his job well, they will get rich. Maxine says that she has no more patience, and that she wants to be famous and have a luxurious life. Wayne tells her that she has to be patient, and that everyone will want her because she has the X factor. Meanwhile, the rest of the team is filming the first scene with Jackson feeding Carr. Bobby Lynn gives RJ some pointers on how to capture the best shots. While Wayne is paying for the groceries, a priest is heard on the TV saying bad things about sex addicts. On the way, they come across an accident in which a truck hit a cow. The team reaches the farmhouse where they will make the movie. Wayne goes to meet the owner, Howard, but Howard aims a gun at him. Wayne has to remind Howard that they talked about renting his place. Meanwhile, Lorraine tells her boyfriend RJ that she wasn't thinking about a porn movie when she agreed to help him with his movie. RJ tells her that you have to start somewhere. However, when Howard sees the rest of the team, he shows that he doesn't like or trust them. Meanwhile, Maxine gets out of the van and sees Howard's wife, Pearl, looking at her through the window. Then Maxine goes swimming in the lake. Before getting out of the water, she doesn't realize that there is an alligator behind her and escapes at the last moment. For a long time, Pearl has been observing her from a distance. Before they start filming, Maxine meets Pearl, who seems to be interested in her. Pearl talks about getting older and complains that she and Howard haven't been intimate in a long time. The team comes together in the farmhouse to shoot the first scene where Jackson and Bobby Lynn have sex. In the following scene, Maxine acts as the younger sister who also has sex with Jackson. While the scene is being filmed, Pearl watches and seems to become sexually excited. She tells Howard that she wants to have sex with him, but he says no because he thinks it might be too much for his heart to handle. On that particular night, Lorraine asks RJ if she can have a role in the movie, but he says no. However, the rest of the group decides to let Lorraine be a part of the movie because she really wants to act in it, not just record the sound. They shoot the scene, but later RJ goes to take a shower and cries because of what happened. RJ gets mad and decides to leave everyone behind, but he stops the car when he sees Pearl standing on the road. He wants to help her get back into the house, but she starts hitting on him and he says no. RJ keeps trying to help, but Pearl takes a knife and stabs him in the neck. She keeps stabbing him until he dies, and blood sprays on the car's headlights. At the same time, Wayne searches for RJ in the farmhouse and accidentally steps on a nail with his bare foot. Then he hears a sound and peeks through a hole in the wall. Suddenly, Pearl stabs him in the eye with a pitchfork, causing him to die. Lorraine stands up to search for RJ, while Howard tells everyone that Pearl cannot be found. Lorraine enters their house to look for her, but Howard locks her in the cellar. While wandering around in the cellar, she suddenly finds a naked man's dead body hanging. Lorraine screams and tries to escape from the cellar. Howard asks Jackson to help search for Pearl. They walk near the lake, and Jackson sees a car submerged in the water. Suddenly, Howard tells Jackson that he knows what Pearl has been doing, and then shoots Jackson with his shotgun, causing him to fall into the water and die. Pearl gets into the bed with Maxine, touches her back, and leaves RJ's blood on her. When Maxine sees Pearl, she screams. Bobby Lynn hears her and tries to help Maxine. She sees Pearl leaving the house and follows her to the lake. Bobby Lynn tries to assist Pearl to return to the house, but Pearl calls her a bad name and shoves her into the lake. An alligator in the lake eats Bobby Lynn. Lorraine takes an axe and tries to break the door to get out, but Howard catches her. Howard hits her fingers with his axe and cuts off one of them. Maxine hides under the couple's bed when they come in. They talk about the murders, and finally, Howard agrees to have sex with Pearl. Maxine secretly leaves and tries to go to the van, but she finds that the keys are missing. Instead, she sees RJ's dead body and takes Wayne's gun from the glove compartment. Maxine went to the basement to rescue Lorraine, but Lorraine got angry at Maxine and accused her of causing the trouble. Later, Lorraine tried to escape the house but got shot in the face by Howard. When he was dragging Lorraine's body inside, she coughed and died, which scared Howard so much that he had a heart attack and died too. Maxine took the keys of a van and pointed her gun at Pearl while they watched a preacher on TV. Maxine said she deserved a good life just like the preacher. But Maxine found out that the gun had no bullets. Pearl shot a shotgun at Maxine but missed, and the force of the recoil threw her out of the house and broke her hip. Pearl asked Maxine for help, but Maxine said no. Maxine got into the van, and Pearl called her a bad name. Maxine ran over Pearl's head 2 times with the van, and it exploded. The next day, Dentler and the other police officers come. The video of the preacher is still playing, and they find out that Maxine is his daughter, and he's looking for her. The deputy finds the camera that was used to make the porn movie. He asks Dentler what he thinks is on it, and Dentler says, "Something very messed up and horrible."